Hello, welcome to Dish Doggy Gaming. I'm Mark. We're at the Northeast Railroad Supply Company. Just leaving the building. Got a little job to do for them today. They've sold a bunch of their coal cars to the SR Mining Company. And contracted us to deliver them to them today. So we're going to run 40 cars up to the coal mine and deliver them to the SR Mining Company facility. And we'll get started here in a minute, but I got another job to take care of, and job's never done till the paperwork's over, so forgive me. I'll see you here in a minute.
One pair of pants later.
Alrighty, put the bucket back. Let's get over to our engine. We're in yard A today, the biggest yard there is here at the railroad. We have three classification yards. We got yard A, a yard B, and a yard C.
Look in both directions, and if a train is coming, don't take chances.
The section foreman has cleared us to leave the yard. Dispatcher is giving us all of our proper paperwork so we can roll out of here. We're going to take a 125 with 40 coal cars up to the coal company, SR Mining. Use my favorite engine, the big mofo. Top this off. Let's see if we can get them up there. I'm on realistic settings, and I have not even tried this. And I don't know how to figure up tractive effort with all the weight. I may not make it. We're going to find out. This engine's pretty much a beast. Let's hope it's got what it takes to get us there. I'm having a little issue here. My cursor is not working. There we go. Got her now. Get some coffee in me. This new engine, this 125, man, I love this thing. It's just a beast. I've turned my graphics settings down a tad. The track's going to pop in and out like this. This feature of the game that I got it maxed out on the settings, but I had edited a file at one time that these were always just basically on. But up here, I have a little 17 FPS. I don't know how accurate it is because it didn't seem like it's really that bad. But 17 FPS ain't good. But don't seem like really like that's really accurate. That's a Steam thing right there. We got a 8-mile-an-hour limit here in the yard. I've never pulled this many cars with this much weight. So I don't know any of the settings for braking, how much percent I'm going to have for the inclines on this railroad. So I'll be learning as I go. There's a Northeast Supply car lot. Buy all of our cars from them. Got the volume turned down on the game. I'm thinking about popping in there real quick and turning it up a little bit. A bit of a grade coming up here. About 3% actually at the end of the turn here. So let's get some power going here. Thank you. on, old man. Get your hand steady here. The weight of these cars, even coming off this little bit, on these cars back here, are going to start pushing me. I like the way the game models that. Now I'm gonna get some speed up, so we're still technically under the 8 mile an hour, but it's been cleared. I can throw the throttle to this. Build up some speed. Let everybody know I'm on my way out. Man, this engine is a beast. That's all I gotta say. We're on realistic settings. 3% grade here going this year. Might even be parts hitting 4. That's one big mofo engine that's just killing it. That's pretty cool. Beautiful. Snake our way up this plateaued, three-tiered plateau from the valley to the top plateau up there. gosh, I love this thing. This game rocks. This is one of the best concept for a train game I think anybody's ever created. It's very unique. Never been done before. Think of all the games that have been out for, 40 years. And they just keep repeating different scenarios over the basic same concept. This is like a brand new concept of a train game that nobody ever thought of. Never been made. And it's just fun as all get out. That's in early access, and it's just the beta. So yeah, there's going to be bugs, and there's going to be problems. Hey, that's what it's all about. You just be patient and work, let them work through it. And good things take a while. They've been working on this a long time. This game started with just one map. And I was not really a fan. I ran my mouth about it, but they shut my mouth. Doing really good work. They've got to a place where we've got Pine Valley map, Lake Valley, and now Aurora Falls, and call it the Alaska map. And this map is huge. Haven't got it completely done yet. There's some industries I don't have anything decorated up on it. All the tracks are laid to everything now. I just finished up the coal area. It's all decorated now. The refinery over here has not been done yet. No decorations over there. I just reworked all the track up at the going to the coal mine yesterday. I ran just this engine over it. It seemed to be okay, but I've not pulled any cars up here. And this one is huge, so cross our fingers and toes. Hope that we are good to go. Right? Got a repair depot up here. We're gonna have to let them know we're rolling through. Full speed. These guys are awesome. They work on everything. Reminds me of that Josh Turner song, Long Black Train. Don't go riding on that long black train. Hit the junction up here where we're going to roll to the left. This is where I started reworking all the section of this part of the line. So from this section here, I'm hoping I didn't forget and leave a tree. Right at the end of this wood trestle, there was a goofy bend right here, and I straightened it out. So we're back to original track here. It's one of them things that you catch as you go along, you know. You know you can rework it later on. Ground over here gets really weird, man. It's like only a 3% grade from this section here. See how tall all this is? All this elevated track from all that all the way back to here, or close to the ground, that's just 3%. But the ground just dives, man, and then hits this hill and comes back up. Just a lot of undulation in this map that just, it's really cool. Makes you really work hard to put a line in. Now all this coming up at the end of this bridge right here, or this trestle, it's all new. I took out all the old and put in the new. The reason is, I used to come off of this and go straight up that valley, and according to the thing, it was set one tiny part was 4%, but it had this weird look to it, optical illusion. It just looked like it was going straight up in the air to the Empire State Building. I'm like, God, this looks horrible. So I snaked it around and cut it back over. This is all new, and I haven't really even run trains up yet other than to test it with just the engine the other day. But it should be, in my opinion, a little prettier to look at. And I put a big trestle in across the valley area. Be a good place to have a lake water here, but it's dry right now. Maybe it fills up later on in the year. What a beast of an engine, man. What a beast. Realistic settings. This turns into flat area right here. Gotta have flat for the bridges, right? just come straight up this, back to that trestle. Just wasn't good looking, didn't look good at all. Top of this hump hill, that's a good name for it, hump hill, man. Because you go, it's like, almost like a pyramid, man. You go up one side and then it wants to go down. Not as steep as the upside, but I hit the top peak of that hill and we are just gonna go downhill to flat level and she'll want to run away. But we are real close. There's a coal mine right there. Alright. I dropped my throttle. That slowed down a little bit. We hit the peak. All this weight behind us. Get some more throttle now. Weight comes over that top and starts pushing down on the engine, it'll pull itself right over that hump. Starting to get some speed. Delivery. See, I got me a switch here that I forgot to set. Got our mine shaft elevator, tag in, tag out house, that's the tag in house, tag out house is back there. That way they know how many miners are down in the shaft at any given time. If you're loading and unloading, Pinkerton. Our company store with Ice House in Alaska. They got plenty of access to ice here. Cold storage all year round. They just finished up the new engine house the other day. And the SR Mining Company has 4 125s in there. And they will deliver all the coal. And these 40 cars are 40 brand new cars for them. Now and then you'll have a sinkhole from a mine collapse. Unfortunately, that's what happened here. You got it all coordinated off, fenced off so that nobody gets hurt. Hopefully it won't collapse anymore. But sometimes that happens with mines. Nice little morning run. right, so we've been asked to pull them around the loop and drop them here, and they will bring their engines out and split the train up and back them into the yard. So that's what we're going to do. Very good. Well, at least we got the job done. The new update has a few little problems. So, sometimes this happens. If you didn't save your game, you were never here. Thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good day.